Hello, Eagles. Good day, everyone. So, ayan. Kamusta po yung review ninyo? Okay, so, alam ko yung iba sa inyo. Wala masyadong time na mag-review. So, this time, we have your summative examination. So, irarasyo ko po sa inyo yung inyong exam. At the same time, ibibigay ko din yung mga related concepts na pwede po natin maisingit para kahit konti lang yung time ninyo na mag-review, makuha nyo naman yung pinaka-main competencies na dapat ninyo ma-master before kayo mag-take ng examination. So, ayan, pakipuha po yung inyong summative materials. So, we have your summative gen ed. Ayan. Ready na, guys? Sige. So, let's start with your question number one. So, our first subject is English. Okay, so we have here the question. The writer's apocalyptic account suggests the end of the world. The capitalized word means. Okay, so we have here the options. Letter A, attractive. B, careless. C, prophetic. D, encouraging. Okay. So, ang ating capitalized word is apocalyptic. Okay. Siyempre, kasi sinabi natin apocalyptic, it means what? Di ba pa sinabi apocalyptic, it pertains to something like prophecy. Okay, from the word apocalypse. So, therefore, ano yung pinaka-perfect word na pwede ninyong gamitin? Okay, so can we use attractive for that? Okay, may end of the world ba na attractive? May end of the world na careless? May end of the world na encouraging? Di ba wala? So, obviously, the answer is letter C. You have the word prophetic. When you say apocalyptic, that is describing or prophesying the complete destruction of the world. So, next question. Your statements are impertinent to the case. The capitalized word means, okay, na ganito yun. When you say impertinent, so we have the word pertinent, meaning it's related, okay, diba? Or it's relevant. But then, we have the prefix im, okay, meaning not, okay, not related, not relevant. So, can we answer the word important? So, syempre pag important, that is something positive, okay? And then, letter B, you have the word irrelevant. Kasi naman, you're not relevant, so possible siya. Letter C, you have the word violent. So, pwede naman siya, pwede din yung violent. And letter D is malicious, okay? Pero syempre, ano ang pinakamalapit, okay? So, we have the word irrelevant. Kasi when you say impertinent, that is not related or not relevant to a particular matter. Okay, so the answer is irrelevant. And next one, she is a vision of feminine pulchritude. The capitalized word means, we have here the word pulchritude. Okay, now you look at the options. We have homeliness, ugliness, plain, and ugliness. So, sinabi natin yung homeliness. Is that positive or negative? That is something negative. Kasi meaning, pang bahay lang yung itsura mo. Or letter B, you have the word loveliness. Is that positive or negative? Okay, it's positive. Letter C, you have the word plain. Positive or negative? Negative. When you say plain, pagkaraniwan. Okay, and letter D, you have the word ugliness. You say ugliness, so syempre negative na yun, diba? So therefore, ano yung naiiba sa kanila? The word loveliness. So the correct answer is letter B. Okay, so pulchritude means loveliness. It is comeliness or physical beauty. Next one, the carriage of the child who saved his brother from a raging fire is worth blood. Okay, so ang tinitingnan natin dito is yung carriage ng child. So, pwede ba natin sabihin na letter D, the carriage of the child is worth watching? So, pinanood mo lang yung carriage ng bata. Or worth narrating? So, pinento mo lang siya. Worth mentoring? Tinuro? Or worth emulating? Okay, ganito yung technique, guys. Di ba yung mga words na watching, narrating, mentoring? So, parang medyo familiar naman siya sa inyo. So, anong word yung parang hindi familiar or medyo difficult? Yung word na emulating. So, di ba nga pagka vocabulary words and then hindi nyo na alam kung anong isasagot, mahanapin nyo na lang kung ano yung mahirap na word. So, that is the correct answer. The answer is emulating. When you say emulating, that is imitating. Okay? But in a way, you are going to surpass or at least match, okay, a person or any achievement. So, that is your emulating. Okay, next question. Shirley has not forgotten that she was betrayed by her best friend and carried such blank in her deeply offended heart for a long time. We have here the word betrayed. Okay, so that is your keyword. Now, ano kaya yung pwede mong maramdaman kung magkaroon ka ng betrayal? So, pwede naman yung word na offense, di ba? So, pwede yung letter D. Letter C, we have the word souvenir. May souvenir ka na betray, ganun. And then, pwede doubt. Pwede ba yung doubt? O, syempre, tanggalin mo na agad yung letter B at letter C. Ang matitira is yung A, rancor, and letter D, offense. Okay, pero di ba nga, ano nga ulit ang competency ulit natin? vocabulary. So, ano yung word na medyo hindi familiar sa inyo? The word rancor. Okay? So, pwede nyo ba siyang isagot? Pwede nyo ba siyang isagot? Yes. Okay, you can answer rancor. Kahit hindi kayo gaano sure kung ano meaning niya. Ano nga bang meaning ng rancor? When you say rancor, that is bitterness. Okay? Or resentfulness, especially when long-standing. So, yung mga matagalang ano, matagalang tampo, ganun, or bitterness, okay? So, that is your rancor. So, since it was betrayal, the correct answer is rancor. Okay, next one. What is the figure of speech in the sentence? The sun was a ball of fire over the mountain. Okay, so ganito yun. Nagkaroon tayo ng comparison. Saan kinumpir yung sun? Sa ball of fire. May ginamit ba na like or as? O, diba? Wala. Pag walang ginamit na like or as, direct or indirect. That is direct comparison without the use of like or as. So the correct answer is metaphor. Okay, the answer is metaphor. The sun was directly compared to the ball of fire without the use of like or as. Okay, number 7. It dropped as a gentle rain from heaven is what figure of speech? So that line was lifted from your Merchant of Venice by William Shakespeare. Sabi doon, it yung mercy kasi ito yung tukoy dyan sa it. Okay, the mercy dropped as a gentle rain from heaven. Kinumpare niya yung mercy sa gentle rain. May ginamit ba na like or as? Yes, so may ginamit na like or as, direct or indirect? Indirect, kasi nga ginamit niya pa ng like or as, diba? So what is indirect comparison with the use of like or as? That is your simile. Okay, the answer is letter B, simile. Okay, question number 8. What figure of speech is the following? He is the black sheep of the family. Oh, actually, yung question na yan, medyo controversial siya. May nag-exist na talaga na black sheep? Wala, diba? So, pinumpir niya kasi yung bata doon sa black sheep. Pero wala naman nag-exist na black sheep. Actually, kung titingnan natin, it will fall into hyperbole kasi medyo exaggerated na yung he is the black sheep, yung black sheep talaga, okay? But then, pag sinabi kasi natin, he is the black sheep of the family, since elementary kayo, hanggang high school, hanggang college, yan ang palaging example natin ng metaphor, okay? So, pag sinabi natin gen ed, di ba nga kailangan sipihan na natin yung pag-iisip dito. So, ganito yun. He is the black sheep of the family, it is still a metaphor. Kasi nagkaroon pa rin tayo, nagkaroon lang naman tayo ng comparison nung he doon sa black sheep, okay? So, you answer metaphor for that, kahit medyo exaggerated siya, okay? Well, number 9, for the select looking figurative expression, it was a black tie affair. What is the equivalent meaning? Okay, sinabi natin party for men only, that is something very literal. Hindi ka pwedeng mag-interpret ng figurative expression as something literal. It should be something beyond. Kasi kung titingnan mo, it is a party for the men only, that is something literal. Kasi sino nagsusuot ng black tie? Diba? Yung mga lalaki, okay? So, ang correct answer dapat natin ay, it is a formal gathering. Bakit naging formal gathering? Because it is a beyond meaning. Kasi pag sinabi mong, it was a black tie affair, okay? Ang nagsuot nun ay yung mga lalaki, okay? But then, pag-iisipin mo, bakit nag-black tie yung mga lalaki? Because it is a formal gathering. So, pag pina-interpret kayo ng figurative expressions and idiomatic expressions, yung gagawin ninyo, guys, kapag literal ang dating ng nandoon sa option, that is not the correct answer. So, you look for something na beyond meaning. Okay, you look for something na beyond meaning. Just like in our question, the answer is formal gathering. That is the beyond the meaning of your black tie affair. Okay? At anong figure of speech yun? Sinek, look, it is a substitution of a part to represent the whole. So, ginamit niya yung black tie to represent the entire outfit of the men who attended the party. Okay? Next one, sinecdoche ulit tayo. For the sinecdoche figurative expression, my mother has a green thumb. I can't wait to show you her garden. What is the equivalent meaning? Okay. Kasi sinabi natin she grows a vegetable garden. So, ando natin yun ang galing. Oh, medyo ano naman siya. Medyo literal na siya. Okay. She cultivates a garden. Pareho lang yung sun nag-grow. She takes care of flowering plants. So, parang nag-gardening pa rin siya. Pero kasi natin, she is good at gardening. Okay. So, hindi naman kasi na-state doon agad-agad na she is good. Okay. Pero yun yung beyond meaning niya. Okay. So, yung green thumb, ang beyond meaning niya is she is good at gardening. At anong figure of speech ulit nga yan? Sinect. Okay. Dahil na-represent niya ang yung thumb, niya represent niya yung whole hand. Okay. Question number 11. By the way, before we proceed to your next question, drill muna tayo ha. Sagutan niyo muna yung mga sumusunod na figures of speech. Okay, so ito yung mga figures of speech na lumabas na the previous season sa board exam. Okay, the first one we have, he was helpless as a child. Ano sagot niyo? Very good, it is simile, kinumpir yung he's a child. Okay, next one we have, it dropped as a gentle rain from heaven. O, na-discuss na yan kanina, that is your simile. Basta sa board exam, paborito ng PRC, simile metaphor. Okay, next one, my mother has a green thumb. I can't wait to show you her garden. Sinekdoke. Oh, wild west wind. What figure of speech is that? Apostrophe, dahil sa ano? Dahil sa wind. O, di ba pag wind, it is non-existing or it cannot answer you. So, the answer is wind. Okay? So, apostrophe. Next one. Wild west wind. May isa pa pala siyang a figure of speech, or actually it's a rhetorical device. Anong tawag dyan? It's alliteration. Bakit? Repetition of the sound W. Wild west wind. So that is your alliteration. Okay? So pag walang alliteration, you can answer apostrophe. Walang apostrophe, you can answer alliteration. Okay? Next one. The sun was a ball of fire over the mountain. So nasagot na natin yan kanina. That is your metaphor. Kinumpira niya yung sun sa of fire. Okay, next one. She is my sunshine. So, she, kinumpir sa sunshine. That is your metaphor. Okay, next one. My head is bloody but unbowed. Okay, so sabi niya, bloody na yung head niya but unbowed. So, that is hyperbole. Exaggeration yun. Okay, bloody na siya pero unbowed pa rin. So, that is exaggeration. Okay, next one. My head is bloody but unbowed. Bakit kaya siya na ulit? Meaning, mayroon pa siyang isang sagot. Okay? Ano pwede isagot? That is also alliteration. Magkakatunog yung bloody but bowed. Okay? Magkakatunog sila. So, alliteration. Okay? Next one. Sturdy and strong, the Filipinos are like the Malave. Okay? So, saan daw kinumpir yung Filipinos sa Malave? At may ginamit tayo na like. So, that is your simile. Okay? Next one. A tree whose hungry mouth is pressed against its sweet flowing breast. Okay, now ganito yun. Ang sabi dyan, yung tree mayroon daw siyang hungry mouth. So, kanino nga ulit attribute yun? Sa human. And what is giving human attribute to inanimate objects? That is your personification. So, the answer is personification. Okay, next one. He was like a snake in the night. Okay, nagkaroon na tayo ng comparison. Pero may ginamit na like. So, ano sagot ninyo? That is your simile. News travels as fast as the wind. So, we have news. Okay, kinumpir niya sa wind. Okay. So, ba't meron tayong ginamit na word na as? Ano nga ulit ang may as? That is your simile. Ay, naku, puro simile metaphor. Okay, next one. I wandered lonely as a cloud. Okay, wandered lonely as a cloud. So, that may word tayo na as. Ano ulit niya? That is your simile. O, sabi ko sa inyo, paborito nila ang simile. Next one. The Lord is my shepherd. Si Lord, kinumpir sa shepherd. So, that is your metaphor. Okay, there the comparison. And next one, he is the black sheep of the family. Black sheep in the family is your metaphor. O souls and spirits of the martyred brave arise. Okay, so, anong figure of speech yan? Apostrophe, dahil sa? Dahil sa ano? Sa souls. Okay, kasi yung, di ba, yung souls, it cannot answer you. Okay, next question.